मुझे कोई आइडिया नहीं था कि एमएलए का मतलब क्या क्या उसका करने का है, मतलब कर क्या सकता है, करना क्या चाहिए उसको. आई नो दैट ही इज अ मेंबर ऑफ लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली. वी आर सपोज टू एनैक्ट लेजिस्लेशन, वी आर सपोज टू इंश्योर दैट यू नो दीज लेजिस्लेशन एक्चुअली आर एग्जीक्यूटेड बाय आर ब्यूरोक्रेसी. दैट्स दैट्स द डेफिनेशन ब्रॉडली. बट एक्सपीरियंस इतने इंटरेस्टिंग होते हैं. मैं एक दिन अपने घर पे हूँ, सुबह 6:30 बजे मुझे एक कॉल आया. दिस वॉज इन 2010. एक हमारा पार्टी का एक छोटा लीडर है सिरसिला में, उसने कॉल किया. इसे भैया अर्जेंट है. मैंने बोला क्या हुआ? बोलता है अभी वाटर का टैंकर आया मेरे गली में, जरा उसको बोल के मेरा जो मेरा पॉट है उसको आगे लगवाने के लिए बोल दो. मैं बोला यार मैं एमएलए हूं, आई एम सपोज टू बी एनैक्टिंग लेजिस्लेशन, और ये आदमी फोन करके मुझे बोल रहा है कि वाटर टैंकर वाले को बोलो मेरा पॉट आगे लगाए. मेरा अब आई वॉज अ बिट परप्लेक्स्ड. आई वॉज लाइक ओके वॉट डू आई डू नाउ? फर्स्टली बिकॉज देर इज नो ओरिएंटेशन सेशन फॉर अ न्यूली इलेक्टेड लेजिस्लेटर. यू नो देर इज नो पब्लिक स्कूल ऑफ पॉलिसी विच काइंड ऑफ गाइड्स अस, टेल्स अस व्हाट टू डू व्हाट नॉट टू डू. आज क्या हो गया ना, बिकॉज ऑफ सोशल मीडिया पर्टिकुलरली, मैं किसी को भी कुछ भी बोल सकता हूं. मैं प्राइम मिनिस्टर को भी बोलता हूं कि मेरा घर के सामने ड्रेनेज ठीक नहीं है, क्या कर रहे हो तुम, तुम्हारा स्वच्छ भारत क्या हो गया? दैट इज अ लेवल ऑफ लिबर्टी पीपल टेक, बिकॉज देयर इज कंफ्यूजन इन टर्म्स ऑफ रोल्स, रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज, डिविजन्स. कोई किसी को कुछ नहीं पता कि किसको बोलना चाहिए, किसको कंप्लेंट करना चाहिए. सी इन इंडिया वी हैव अ ब्यूटिफुल सिस्टम ऑफ यू नो 5-tier सिस्टम ऑफ यू नो गवर्नेंस. वी हैव द यूनियन गवर्नमेंट, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स, जिला पंचायत, जिला परिषद, वी हैव यू नो तालुका पंचायत, एंड देन वी हैव द ग्राम पंचायत, द 5-tier गवर्नेंस. And there is also the municipal, which kind of is parallel to all of these. So, ab councillor ko kya karna chahiye, sarpanch ko kya karna chahiye, aur ZPTC ko kya karna chahiye, mandal parishad president ko kya karna chahiye, zila parishad chairman ko kya karna chahiye, MLA ko kya karna chahiye, MP ko kya karna chahiye. Ye role clarity jo hai na, isme bahut confusion hai. Aur is confusion mein, it is compounded by the bureaucracy's, you know, inherent resistance to change. So initially when we started our journey, when our honorable chief minister said hame raitu bandhu karna hai, in fact I'll send you a sorry harita haram karna hai, we plant 230 crore saplings, I'll send you a write up. In fact one of our bureaucrats, her name is Shweta Mahanti, she was Hyderabad collector until 3 days ago. She just went on a she's gone to Kennedy, in fact I think she's going to Harvard for a 1 year I think course on public policy,
public administration, maybe.
Public administration. Yeah. So she wrote a paper, she gave it to me before she left. She wrote a paper on how skeptical she was on day one when honorable chief minister said 230 crore plantation karna hai. Pehli baat, jab bhi koi aisa radical thought sochte ho, radical idea aata hai kisi ke man mein, to hame lagta hai ki ye to kya hai yaar, ye namumkin hai, nahi ho sakta hai. So there is that inherent change, inherent resistance. So in our case, when we said Mission Bhagirath, we want to give drinking water connection to each and every home, engineers said no, not possible. We go to Gujarat, even they laugh at us. They say no, nahi nahi ho sakta. India mein kisi ne kiya hi nahi, tum kya karoge? Naya raj hai, tumhe pata hi nahi tumhara kya financial resources kya hai, kaise karoge? So all these challenges, but I think one thing that Telangana has shown is that if you have the political will, if you have that ability in you to drive a project with a mission mode, things can happen, things will happen. Even bureaucracy initial, after initial resistance, they'll fall in line. They'll also say, okay, inka irada theek hai, inka irada naik hai, to karenge, kuch kar sakte hain. So fundamental challenge is bureaucracy, one, firstly. Secondly, finances. Finances, you know, even our institutions, financial institutions in India, are not used to leveraging our economy. Dar jate hain log. Aap ek, kyunki you're all students of public policy, you should understand economics also. एक गवर्नमेंट चलाना और एक घर चलाना बहुत अलग बात है. घर चलाना मतलब बजटिंग के हिसाब से ठीक ऑलमोस्ट सेम है, बट देर आर लॉट ऑफ चेंजेस. सी फॉर एग्जाम्पल, लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंसेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द इकोनॉमी ऑफ तेलंगाना टुडे, आर पर कैपिटा इनकम इज मोर देन डबल्ड इन द लास्ट 7 ईयर्स, विच इज अगेन बाय नो मीन्स अ स्मॉल फीट. वी आर मच मच अबव द कंट्रीज पर कैपिटा इनकम, नेशनल एवरेज पर कैपिटा इनकम. हाउ डिड दैट हैपन? That happened because we are leveraging our economy. Hum log dar nahi jate hain debt se. Because as long as you have taken a debt and have invested in a productive, have invested it in a productive sector. Humne jab debt liya Mission Bhagirath ke liye ya irrigation ke liye, humne ye soch ke liya ki एक रुपया अगर हम डेट लेते हैं, इसको कैसे हम तब्दील कर सकते हैं 2 या 3 रुपया में? एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर एबल टू रोटेट दैट रूपी, एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर एबल टू लेवरेज योर इकोनॉमी प्रॉपरली, एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर एबल टू क्रिएट मोर वेल्थ, आई थिंक यू विल बी इन गुड शेप. बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली आर फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस इन इंडिया, बी इट योर बैंक, बैंक्स और अदर फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस, दे आर अ बिट एप्रिहेंसिव व्हेन इट कम्स टू लेंडिंग. And as such, our Indian mentality also, you know, we have FRBM and other restrictions, you know that. Fiscally responsible, budgetary monitoring, etc. You know, all of these, challenges that go with a new project being conceptualized definitely ought to be worked out. And the third challenge, I would say, are inherent to our governance systems. For example, hum ek irrigation project banana chahte hain, additional irrigation area under cultivation lana chahte hain. उससे एनवायरमेंट को, बायोडाइवर्सिटी को फायदा होगा या नुकसान होगा? इस बात को लेकर दिल्ली में एमओईएफ में बहुत चर्चा होता है, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरमेंट एंड फॉरेस्ट, और बहुत सारे हर्डल भी लगाए जाते हैं. सो ऑल ऑफ दीज चैलेंजेस वी फेस्ड इन द लास्ट 7 years, फाइनेंशियल, ब्यूरोक्रेटिक एंड जनरल माइंड सेट चैलेंजेस, इंस्टीट्यूशनल चैलेंजेस, बट आई थिंक टू अ ग्रेट एक्सटेंट वी बीन एबल टू ओवरकम.
थैंक यू सर. रॉसन ऑफ द ग्रे शर्ट.
Good morning, sir. My name is Rosan Gonsalves.
So
one thing that we have seen world over is the effect of climate change, including our country. You're the Minister of Municipal Administration and Urban Development. So I want to understand from you, how is sustainability and climate risk incorporated in policy making, especially in these portfolios that you hold?
Roshan, right?
Rosan.
Yeah.
Which part of India are you from, Rosan?
Mumbai, sir.
Mumbai. Rosan, two, three things. You know, climate change is real. It's no more what we read in books, etc. I think if you look at the UN report a couple of days ago, they've even said, you know, code red for humanity. They said, high time you guys take charge, otherwise there's no humanity. So it is real. But what is happening also, since you talked urban development, is whatever urbanization that has happened in last 5,000 years, double or, you know, triple of that is going to happen in next 50 years. That's how much urbanization is happening across the world, not just India. In fact, suburbanization and urbanization are two phenomena which no government in India has been able to tackle. Not in India, across the world. In fact, China tried it. They said, in fact, they even came out with a permit system for people to move from rural areas to, you know, urban pockets. And they said, we'll only permit a certain number and not more, so that rapid urbanization can be contained. But nobody has been successful. Now, why do people actually move? Why do people migrate? Why do people urbanize? I think we need to answer that question firstly. Firstly, for better livelihood, better healthcare, better employment, better education opportunities. These are the three things. Now, when people do migrate, what happens is obviously the urban infrastructure, which is never on par with our growing urbanization, will crumble. What happens when urban infrastructure crumbles? I was just looking at the road leading to GITAM. I should tell Bharat, you know, to also lay a better road all the way from road till your university. Yeah, modne ke baad theek hai, but wahan tak theek nahi hai.
आपको I have something to say on this, but after this is over, I'll tell you.
Come on, you should be doing some CSR also, no, Geetam? What do you guys say? Clap if you agree with me. See, Bharat, they all agree with me. Point is, this will happen. There's no substitute. I mean, the kind of population that we are. Look at Hyderabad. We are one of the largest cities in India. We are among one of the 7 largest metros in India. And our population grows every year, every month, every day, every week. Are we on par? I think we are much better than any other city in India, but I can't be relatively happy, right? Our drinking water, in fact, we don't have to get pani in tankers like Chennai does. We are not as bad as Mumbai in a lot of counts in terms of infrastructure. Mera ek dost aaya tha Mumbai se, 2-4 din pehle, wo bol raha tha ki aapka infrastructure humse behtar hai. To maine kaha, main relative comfort to nahi lunga, but thank you. Sustainability ki jab aap baat karte ho, Roshan, I think we are doing our bit, but it's just not enough. I think it can't just be the role of a government. And the word sustainability, it permeates into all sectors, all spheres of life. It's not just confined to rural development or urban development or industry or, you know, or this or that. I can't confine myself to that. It kind of permeates into all of that. And unless we as humanity collectively take charge, a government by itself can't do it. Telangana government has launched what is called as Haritaharam, one effort. Now, Government of India has yesterday announced that all ban on plastic from July next year. I'm thinking to myself, you know, I want to do it as a responsible citizen, but what is the substitute for plastic? Wo to dikhao pehle. सस्ता जो सब्स्टिट्यूट है वो दिखा के बात करो. ऐसे ही पॉलिसी बनाने से कुछ नहीं होता है, स्लोगन देने से कुछ नहीं होता है. अगर मैं कल तक बोल दूं पूरा इंडिया को डिजिटाइज करो, उससे क्या होता है? उसका डिजिटल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर चाहिए, डिजिटल लिटरेसी चाहिए, डिजिटल अवेयरनेस चाहिए, ट्रेनिंग चाहिए, स्किल अपग्रेडिंग चाहिए. ये सब करने के बाद अगर आप स्लोगन देते हो तो सक्सेसफुल होगा. सस्टेनेबिलिटी पे भी हमारी गवर्नमेंट ने कुछ किया है, बट आई थिंक देयर इज लॉट मोर टू बी डन, बट दिस हैज टू बी डन कलेक्टिवली एंड नॉट जस्ट कांट बी अ गवर्नमेंट्स रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी.
थैंक यू. So in the students, I want the ones who haven't yet asked a question. So if you have, then put your hand down so that I know who hasn't asked a question. Are you cheating? Okay, yeah. Red shirt here.
Good morning, sir. My name is Audambar and I come from Kolhapur, Maharashtra. My question is, how does this public policy course will help me to work at the grassroots level? Because when we have a discussion in our cohort, most of the people think that they want to work at the international level, international organizations or the central government like Niti Aayog. But if I come from grassroots, how do you think there will be an opportunity to work at the district level or block level?
What did you say your name was?
Your name.
Audambar. Audumbar.
Audumba. Yeah. Unique name, boss. Matlab kya hua iska?
It's a local traditional Marathi name for deity Brahma.
Achha, deity Brahma. Nice. Audumbar. Good meeting you. Yeah. How does it help me at a grassroots level? Yeah. Great question. Please sit. Firstly, I think there is no substitute to real learning, boss. Kyunki maine koi course to liya nahi. Aur main jab chunke aaya ek legislator banke, mujhe lage 3-4 saal samajhne mein, seekhne mein. Kyunki जितना भी हम लोग पढ़ाई करते हैं, जैसे अगर आप इंजीनियरिंग भी करते हो या कोई भी कोर्स करते हो, जब तक आप एक्चुअली रियल वर्ल्ड में जाके काम नहीं करते, जब तक आपकी हैंड्स डर्टी नहीं करते, टिल यू गेट योर हैंड्स डर्टी, यू वॉन्ट रियली कॉम्प्रीहेंड यू नो द रियल वर्ल्ड प्रॉब्लम्स. बिकॉज हम जो सीखते हैं, समझते हैं, हमें जो पढ़ाया जाता है वर्सेस जो एक्चुअल सच्चाई है, बहुत ज़्यादा बार फर्क होता है. हाउ डज इट हेल्प? इट डज हेल्प यू you know, go in better prepared. See, if you want to sort of implement policy at a, you know, grassroots level, you said Zilla Parishad level or a block level, it will help you understand ki government of India ki ya state government ki jo policy making hai aur uska implementation hai, usme kya kamiyan hai, usko aap kaise matlab properly exploit kar sakte ho, ya usko properly aap, how will you be able to convince people or help people understand ki kya kya banaye. Bahut sare baar kya hota hai na, hum jo kanun banate hain parliament mein ya legislature mein, मैं सच बोलूं तो इसका ज्यादातर पार्लियामेंटेरियंस और लेजिस्लेटर्स को भी पूरी तरह से अंदाजा नहीं होता है. हम लोग हाँ या ना बोल देते हैं, आई यस नो यस, खत्म, बिल पास कर दिए, हो गया. बट कितने लोग एक्चुअली पढ़ते हैं, फाइन प्रिंट कितने लोग देखते हैं, और उसका जो इम्प्लीमेंटेशन है जिसमें बहुत सारा फायदा हो सकता है लोगों को, वो कितने लोग समझ पाते हैं? नाउ दैट इज वेयर यू गाइज कैन कम इन एंड हेल्प बोथ द पब्लिक रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स एंड द पब्लिक. एंड आई थिंक यू कैन बी दैट ब्रिलियंट ब्रिज बिटवीन people who make these legislations and people who actually are expected to be the beneficiaries. So aap agar aap koi experiment, agar aap koi ek act lete ho, for example one of the more popular acts in India is right to information. Jab kanoon banaya gaya, initially uska power shayad zyada logon ko samajh nahi aaya hoga, but baad mein jaisa activists have started using it, NGOs have started using it and have started exposing their governments at Zilla level, at state level, at central government level. Today the politicians are more alert. Ki bhai RTI mein pucha jayega, kuch hum log anshan karte hain, gadbad karte hain, aur jo cheez hum nahi kar sakte hain, agar wo karte hain aur commit ho jate hain, to ye bahar aayega zarur ek na ek din. Ye dar unke matlab man mein kahin baitha rehta hai. Aur jab ek civil society ek bahut alert rehti hai aur chusti se kaam leti hai, jaise aap ho, trained ho, to you can certainly contribute. You can work as a checkmate to both public representatives at a certain level, to governments, and also you can help people ki ek act ya ek legislation kaise kaise uska fayda hum utha sakte hain. Jaisa abhi maine bola DBT ke bare mein bola, aapko shayad yaad hoga Rajiv Gandhi ji ne ek bar kaha tha, prime minister the wo, tab unhone kaha tha ki main Delhi mein ek rupya agar release karta hu, wo niche aate aate 16 paisa ban jata hai, beech mein koi 84 paisa kha jata hai. This is what prime minister of India said, not me. बट आज जब DBT आ गया, मैं रईतु बंधु अभी बोल रहा था, मैं रईतु बंधु जब आ गया तो 100% पैसा फार्मर को मिलता है, यहां हैदराबाद में रिलीज करते हो उनके अकाउंट में 100% जाता है। हमको देख के पीएम साहब ने भी इंस्पिरेशन लिया और उन्होंने पीएम किसान चालू कर दिया, अच्छी बात है। तो ये सारे चीज जो है मतलब स्टडी करने के लिए डीबीटी, अब बहुत सारे इकोनॉमिस्ट बोलते हैं कि डीबीटी बहुत अच्छी प्रोग्राम है, हम रायतु बंधु हमने चालू किया, एक और प्रोग्राम हमने चालू किया यहाँ पे कल्याण लक्ष्मी, लड़की मतलब अगर बालिक है 18+ है उनके शादी के गरीब है तो तेलंगाना गवर्नमेंट 1,00,000+ रुपये देती है। इससे क्या हो गया ना, यहाँ पे चाइल्ड मैरिजेस कम हो गए और यहाँ पे हम लोग एक KCR किट करके देते हैं इंस्टीट्यूशनल डिलीवरी को इंकरेज करने के लिए, उससे आज तेलंगाना में इंस्टीट्यूशनल डिलीवरी फ्रॉम 30% to 50% बढ़ गया, इन्फेंट मोर्टैलिटी कम हो गया, मेटर्नल मोर्टैलिटी कम हो गया और सिजेरियन ऑपरेशन कम हो गया। ऑल ऑफ दिस कैन बी स्टडीड बाय यू गाइस, यू कैन एक्सप्लेन टू पीपल एंड द लॉ मेकर्स कि कौन सा चीज काम करता है, कौन सी आपकी पॉलिसी काम कर रही है और कौन सी फेल हो गई है, लोगों को भी समझा सकते हैं और दूसरी तरफ आप एक ड्यूअल रोल प्ले करके गवर्नमेंट्स को भी समझा सकते हैं, एंड आई थिंक पब्लिक पॉलिसी विल हेल्प यू अचीव दैट।
आई थिंक दैट्स अ ग्रेट ग्रेट सजेशन। We get the pink lady here.
Okay, I had the mic.
Okay. Oh, you have the, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, Poonam, go for it.
Hi.
Namaskaram, KTR Garu, I'm Poonam.
Hi.
And first of all, I would like to congratulate you for Ramappa on a cultural aspect. You've spoken about beautiful policies which have been undertaken by your government. And first thing I would like to know that what are the steps taken when you come up with a policy? And secondly, the recent Dalit Bandhu scheme which has been announced, is it really practical? Because the amount of money which has been announced for Dalit Bandhu, why right now? And the amount of money which will be, you know, spent on that scheme is huge. So is it even practical? That's my question.
Thank you, Poonam. Firstly, thanks on Ramappa. I think it's a great honor for Telangana and the country also. In fact, to get UNESCO World Heritage Tag for one of our brilliant, traditional heritage structures. And it was the first structure in Telangana, which again, I'm very, very proud of. And hopefully we'll even get that for Hyderabad eventually, because Hyderabad, I keep saying, is one of those rare cities which has a combo of both heritage and the new age vibe. So Hyderabad should get it also. Let's all work towards it. Now, your question about practicality of Dalit Bandhu and other schemes. Poonam, 2-3 things for you to think. Firstly, yes, it's a bold reform. It's very, very bold. It's very, very radical. And our Honorable Chief Minister can only dream big. That's his problem. He can't think small. He can't think big, dream small. When he thought about Raitu Bandhu, the same question popped up. A lot of people said, is it practical? Is it feasible? Will it work? We've not only done Raitu Bandhu successfully, we have now set the tone for the rest of the country. Today about 11 states have come out with their own programs. In Odisha they call it Kalia, in Bengal they call it Krishak Bandhu, I think it's called. And like I said, Honorable Prime Minister himself took it upon, I think he took so much liking to the scheme, he also adopted it, he calls it PM Kisan. So Raitu Bandhu became a trendsetter that way. Like I told you, Mission Bhagirath, again it became a source of inspiration for Jal Jeevan Mission, and today they are trying to implement it across the country. Mission Kakatiya again has become a role model for the rest of the country. I firmly believe, Poonam, that 75 years of independence, Azadi ke Amrutotsav, kya bolte ho? Amrit whatever, Amrutotsav, right. So Prime Minister ji ne bulaya tha hame pichli saal. Bula ke unhone pucha tha, all political parties he had called. He conducted a meeting, he said, bataiye ab kya kya karna chahiye. 150 साल बापू के बर्थ एनिवर्सरी और आज़ादी के 75 ईयर्स, क्या क्या करना चाहिए. तो उसमें मैं भी गया था एज अ पार्टी फंक्शनरी फ्रॉम TRS. सो आई टोल्ड हिम थ्री थिंग्स. सर, आई सेड द 3I मंत्र, इफ इंडिया रियली हैज टू प्रोपेल इटसेल्फ इनटू द नेक्स्ट लीग ऑर्बिट, नेक्स्ट ऑर्बिट, द 3I मंत्र इज व्हाट आई थिंक वी ऑट टू बी फोकसिंग ऑन. इनोवेशन, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, इंक्लूसिव ग्रोथ. नाउ आई विल स्टार्ट विद द थर्ड वन, इंक्लूसिव ग्रोथ. मैं क्या बोल रहा हूं इंक्लूसिव ग्रोथ माने, आज अगर आप इंडिया में देखते हो 75 ईयर्स के बाद, लाइक आई थिंक ओबामा और समबडी सेड वेरी फेमसली, देयर आर टू अमेरिकास, यू नो देयर इज दैट अमेरिका एंड देयर इज यू नो दिस अमेरिका. लाइकवाइज इंडिया एक इंडिया है, एक भारत है. आज इंडिया में 75 ईयर्स के बाद भी दलित की अगर आप हालत देखोगे तो बहुत खराब है, इन स्पाइट ऑफ रिजर्वेशन, इन स्पाइट ऑफ वॉट एवर हैज बीन डन. सो इफ यू लुक एट इट, you know, the model for 20th century, when it was about Dalits and how do we emancipate them, it was through social justice reservations. But 75 years of experimentation has not worked. When plan A doesn't work, you have to think radically, you have to come to some other alternative. Now, why only Dalits? A lot of people question. Why can't it be, why is there no minority bandhu? Why is there no tribal bandhu? Why is there no BC bandhu? Why not other subgroups and social groups? Is it good to kind of segregate the society and do it this way? I would say, most definitely, if you look at any statistics, socio-economic indicators and statistics, Dalits as a community across the country, while they are scheduled under the constitution, they're a scheduled category under the constitution, they're still the most downtrodden on any socio-economic indicator in the country. And they form a significant percentage of our population. They are about 16 to 17% in Telangana. And if you look at the country, I think I'm not very sure about the number, but it's quite substantial. If you leave out a certain sizable section of the population, even after 75 years, ignore them and continue to ignore them in spite of knowing fully well that none of your previous policies have worked, I think we are doing a great injustice, not just to ourselves, but our country and our future generations also. This is, yes, it's a bold experiment. It will require a lot of capital. But like I was pointing out to Vinaya, in my previous question, aap agar ek bar theek se samajhte ho, we are not just giving away money. It's not like we are giving away money unhinged and unconditional. We are saying ki each family ko jo 10 lakh rupaya diya jayega under Dalit Bandhu, it has to be productively leveraged and it has to be converted, it has to be doubled or tripled over a period of time. That's the goal. And we are not just going to give money and, you know, let them be. Our collectors, our nodal officers will work with them in helping set up mini dairies, in helping set up rice mills, in helping set up small micro units. And we'll ensure that somebody will move from BPL, below the poverty line,